In this video, you'll learn how to use Adobe Premiere Pro. You'll learn how to set up a project, edit on the timeline, add transitions and effects, adjust color, edit audio, and export. Use the clickable sections below to skip to different parts of this tutorial. Click New Project here. Give your new project a name and choose where you want it to be saved. Click OK. The easiest way to import media is to simply drag and drop it onto the media panel here. To better organize your media clips in the media panel, you can put them in folders called bins. Click New Bin here to create a new bin. You'll now be given the opportunity to name it. You can now drag and drop media clips into your bin, and double-click the bin to open it up. Click back here to go back to the Master Media panel. You can drag and drop media straight onto your timeline. Video clips will be added to video channels, and audio clips will be added to audio channels below. To only add a section of a clip to your timeline, double-click the clip in your media panel and it'll appear in the source window here. Use the in and out markers to mark the section of the clip you want to add. Now when you drag and drop it onto the timeline, it'll only add that section. A message may appear asking if you want your timeline settings to match the settings of the clip you're dragging onto it. Click Change Sequence Settings to make your sequence settings match the settings of this first clip. You can always modify your sequence settings by going to Sequence, then Sequence Settings. Now that your media clips are on the timeline, you can move them around by clicking and dragging, and shorten or elongate by clicking and dragging from either end. You can also move the video or audio to different video or audio channels. You can unlink linked video and audio by right-clicking and selecting Unlink. The video and audio tracks will then be able to be moved separately. Note that if you move a clip on top of another, it'll automatically overwrite it. Press Command and Z to undo. Use the plus and minus keys to zoom in and out of your timeline. Use the Cut tool to cut a clip into two separate clips along a point. Each of these clips will then be able to be moved and edited independently of one another. Use the Selection tool to move and edit them. Use the spacebar, or hit play here, to play your edit in the viewer window from your playhead position. Transitions can be found under Video Transitions here. Choose the transition you want and drag it onto either end of your clip. Click and drag to change the duration of the transition. You can place a transition between two adjacent clips to transition between them. Effects can be found under Video Effects here. Click and drag your desired effect onto a clip. You can then modify your effect under the Effect Controls tab here. Color adjustments can be made using the Lumetri Color effect. Find Lumetri Color under Color Correction in Video Effects and click and drag onto a clip. Under the Effects Control panel, you'll now be able to make all your color adjustments to this clip, including contrast, saturation, temperature, and many more. Audio effects and transitions can be found here, and act in the same way as video effects and transitions. Simply drag and drop them onto audio clips, and modify under Effect Controls. You can make each track bigger or smaller to view by clicking and dragging here. Click and drag this line up or down on the audio clip to adjust the volume level. Once you're happy with your edit, you can export by clicking File, Export, then Media. Choose here whether you want to export the entire timeline or just between the in and out markers on your timeline. Choose your output format here, and choose further video and audio output settings here. Give your file a name and choose its destination here. Click Export to begin exporting.